थैंक यू वेरी मच विनायक सर, यू हैव वाइडली स्पोकन अबाउट माय डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द प्रोफेशनल कैरियर्स। तो आई एम नॉट प्रैक्टिसिंग स्ट्रक्चरल कंजर्वेशनिस्ट और प्रोफेशनली आर्किटेक्ट कंजर्वेशन। बेसिकली आई एम ए टीचर, सो व्हेन एवर आई टॉक अबाउट द जनरल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ स्ट्रक्चरल कंजर्वेशन इशूज अबाउट द वेराइटी ऑफ मोन्यूमेंट्स इन इंडिया, यू विल फाउंड इंडिया इज ए प्लूरिस्टिक कंट्री, सो वी हैव द आर्किटेक्चरल इमेंस ऑफ इन ए डाइवर्सिफाइड टाइप। सो एवरी मोन्यूमेंट रिक्वायर्ड ए वेरी स्पेसिफिक स्ट्रक्चरल कंजर्वेशन प्लानिंग मेथड टेक्निक एंड टेक्नोलॉजिकल सोल्यूशन ऑफ ईच ऑफ द मोन्यूमेंट्स। सो फर्स्ट आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस अबाउट द माई इंटायर प्रेजेंटेशन डिवाइडेड इन टू थ्री पार्ट। ओके present entire window screen. So now it's visible. Hello.
Yes, sir. It is visible.
So my entire presentation divided into three parts. First is the definition of the different reservation.
You can sir click on the hide button so that you can hide the bar that in the bottom hide.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. So first part I will giving the basics of definition that is not written in the book. It is the basically I have designed to understand the common people or the general people what is the conservation, then the prevailing practices, and in prevailing practices I will discuss the different intervention on the conservation. Then whenever you intervene on any things, there must be some ethics. So what is the ethics? About the ethics, we have the several national and international charters, law, act, what have to do and what to have not to do. Then method and technique. In method and technique, I will discuss what type of methodology required for our structural heritage, or you can say architectural heritage, because it's a single structure not constructed in a 1 or 2 years. It has more than 10 to 20 years every structure. Whenever I go for the sites, you will found the hundreds of years history of construction, hundreds of years of alteration and its intervention in that. So there is a big challenges for a conservator, what to do or what not to do. Then we will discuss about the different structural conservation techniques, and finally the conclusion is versus technological issues or technological solution versus the indigenous technology. So what are the difference between the modern technology or advanced technology we have or we use, and how the advanced technology is effective in comparison to the indigenous technology. So these are the my theme of the presentation. So first I will show you this is the picture of Taj Mahal, where the storm is came and how the minaret is broken down in a storm. It's the entrance gate of the Taj Mahal. You must have heard in the newspaper and all these things. So, and here the in the structural conservation, you see what are the technique they have used for structural consolidation or for the structural reproduction. They have used this iron rod in that, and there is a three rod, so it's already broken, but they have repaired it. But due to the span of the time and the different technological faults and storms or rigorous environmental condition, how it has been collapsed. So this is the one of the example. The second one is C. Above the turret there is a pinnacle that is also fall down and got cracks. And here you see the white marks that these are the binding cum filling material has been used at the time of conservation. So this is the one example of conservation and structural conservation issues in India. Then next you see this is the huge temple. Everybody heard about the Khajuraho, and Khajuraho is widely popular for the erotic sculpture, but there is also Shiv temple. This is called Vijay Mandal at Khajuraho, and here you think about what and how a conservation approach and what type of method approach to be restored of these temples, because it's a huge temple and huge sites, and without anatomy of the structure, no one able to reconstruct it or repair it or reproduce it. So here I would like to stay and discuss all the 7 degrees of intervention internationally accepted. The first one is conservation. So what is conservation? So you see, in a life there is a change is the permanent phenomenon of this universe, but every human being or everybody or every science or every technology has produced for what? For desirable change, for desirable change. So in any structure or any fabric or any antiquities or any immovable property, if any undesirable changes are occurred, that is termed as a deterioration. And managing the change according to your desire is called conservation. So some of the book written, slow the rate of deterioration is called conservation, arresting the rate of decay is called conservation. It's okay. But why this all mechanism and action has to be taken place? You required a desirable change. But change is the universe phenomena. When the things get created, there must have to degraded and deteriorated. It's a fact. It's a phenomenal fact. So here is the Vijay Mandal at Khajuraho. You see how the temple has been collapsed and disappears, and what kind of approaches is required. So first thing is conservation. Second one is preservation. Freeze the existing states. तो एक कंजर्वेशन का अप्रोच ये हो सकता है कि जो भी स्थिति में हमें ये दिख रहा है, हम इसको इसी स्टेज में कंसोलिडेट कर दे बाय डिफरेंट स्ट्रक्चरल टेक्निक्स। देन थर्ड वन इज कॉल्ड रिपेयर। इफ देयर इज ए ब्रोकन पार्ट्स ऑफ दिस हेयर इज अ मंडल, देन यू कैन एबल टू रिप्रोड्यूस इट और रिपेयर इट। सो रिपेयर, रिप्रोडक्शन, then rejuvenation. If there is a water body in Khajuraho, whenever anyone has visited, then you found most the temple has constructed near the source of water bodies. So if the structural conservation, you conserve the structure, you simultaneously you conserve the water bodies, also termed as a rejuvenation. Then next one is called anastalosis. So here the process has to be used according to international intervention is anastalosis. Whatever you found the broken material or collapsed material of these temples, you scientifically clear it and collect it and then classified it on the basis of its base, is the basis of the wall, on the basis of the superstructure, on the basis of all the classification has to be done, and accordingly you try to reconstruct. So conservation is a process to get their original face or the shape in their original form is called conservation. Or you can say the conservation is a study to reconstruct the past for better understanding of the past. And the another definition also, architecture is a language of that particular era. Architecture से हमें ये पता चलता है कि उस time का राजा का साइकोलॉजिकल जो साइकोसिस था, जो पॉलिटिकल अप्रोच था, जो उसका इकोनॉमी था, उस टाइम में जो आम जन लोग थे, जो कॉमन मैन था, उनका किस चीज से लगाव था, अकॉर्डिंगली यू विल फाउंड द आर्किटेक्चर. सो दैट इज व्हाई इन नॉर्थ इंडिया वी फाउंड नागर स्टाइल ऑफ टेम्पल, इन साउथ इंडिया वी फाउंड द्रविड़ियन स्टाइल ऑफ टेम्पल, एंड व्हेनेवर इन द सेंट्रल द मिड पार्ट ऑफ द इंडिया वी फाउंड द बेसर स्टाइल ऑफ टेम्पल्स. बट all the kings are fighting each other against each other, but they has to be constructed the temples either in South India or North India. The fight is totally different, and construction and production of the temples are the totally different. So it's a one of the challenge of the heritage parts. Next is this is the entrance gate of the Taj Mahal, and this is the another view of that Vijay Mandal of Khajuraho. Here you can see the water bodies also. So here is the Shiv temples. You will found the water bodies here in at Vijay Mandal at Khajuraho. And these are the different approaches taken by the Archaeological Survey of India to classify and find out the structural remains of that temples. And these are the current scenario of this Vijay Mandal temples at Khajuraho. And these are the plinth levels. And here you can see different kinds of moldings and different kinds of problem occur here also. Here you can see the different type of crack as well as visible. Here you can see. So these are the challenges. What type of conservation technique and technological, what are the technological solution available to restore these kind of temples? So we have different conservation techniques and technology available which can be used to analyze. So in structural conservation, you have to keep in mind three things always simultaneously. First one is the analytical tools and technology. Second one on the materials analysis and available technology. And third one, execution. So these three steps are very much essential on the structural conservation parts in India, because every monument has a own structural problem. There is a own individual, or you can say own characteristic problems on that particular site. So next. Here you see, this is the Nandi. And Nandi here is installed in a rectangular post hole installed. But what is happening here? This is the Udayagiri. This is the rare Nandi where you can found the dressing of the Nandi. Mayana is dressing the Nandi and tying the different types of Rasi. But it is not structurally restored here. It's only aligned the structure in front of Shiv temple. So this is the another structural problem, and this is the next type of problem of the Mughal monuments. You found the Salim Chishti Darga at Fatehpur Sikri. Here is the problem. What is the major problem? You see, this is the screen work, but whenever the restoration has been taken place, they have only make the hole, and that hole does not serve their authenticity and integrity of the monument as per Nara Charter, because Nara Charter says authenticity and integrity of the monument should not be disturbed at any cost. So these are the problems you will get at the various monuments. Here you also found, and next slide I will show you the different aspects. See, this is the Taj. Here is the Salim Chishti Darga. This is the propping technique used. Here you will get the evidence how this has been cracked. You see, here is the crack is happened, and they have used propping. So propping, one of the temporary support, this technique is called propping. Propping is the one of the temporary support which is provided from the bottom support to the cracked or unsafe structural element. So propping technique here also has been used, and here is another, this is also propping, but this is called propping pillar. Here you can see this is the crack and how they have refill it. So this is the technological, you can say, option. So there you have used the wood steel tube, and here you have used a stone pillar. See, this is one of the interesting on the structural conservation part. these are the escape folding. So whenever I will speak on escape folding, it's a various type, various use. So what is escape folding? Escape folding is also temporary support which provide us accessibility to the desired part for conservation or construction purposes is called escape folding. So escape folding is also provide the temporary support to the structure or temporary support to the access the desirable space at the sites. So here you can see these are the paper pulp has been used because this is the seashore area, seashore. So there is a chloride found in the atmosphere and that is called SPM, suspended particulate matter in the environment, and that damage the structural fabric of that temple. So that has been to be taken place to removal of salt. They have used the paper pulp method. And another the important thing happened here in the conservation part, they have used endoscopic method to test the inside what kind of problem is occur and what kind of supporting has been used, because this Jagmohan is filled by sand, some of the report says. But what is actually, so recently the ASI and their expert team also used, and they have probing method done by the endoscopy. The another thing also happened here, the structurally which is important, that is called geodetic survey. Geodetic survey is a basically survey probing below the ground to check their groundwater position or capillary action point of view, or you can say cohesiveness of the soil. All type of test has been done here, because there is a one consultant company, Caltech India, in last in 1990 to 2000 they have approached that the temple is sinking, so they have done that kind of survey. So here is a lots of technological innovation is required for structural conservation, for uplifting the object, also the uplifting of demigod or semigods. You see here these are the picture you seeing, these are the sculpture are life size. So these are the different instrument beaters, bowmans. Here you will found again same similar kind of the instrument playing women's are depicted, and these are in life size. So whenever you visit on the side, you cannot see by your eye. So what you have to do, you have to take the photograph by a very good camera that has a good resolution quality, and these are the different animals also depicted. So it's a huge sculpture and in heavy weight. So here you have to compare it, whether the modern technique is able to hold this kind of structure or uplift this kind of structure on that much of height, or there is a, in it you have to opt about your traditional indigenous method for uplifting these kind of huge weight elements for restoration or structural conservation purposes. So this is based on your observation or your consciousness, what you have to do, because you have the both the option is available, modern or advanced technology by using of crane and all these things, or you have the indigenous chain and pulley method to uplift the things, or there is a originally they have constructed by the making or the construction of ramp of the near the sides to uplift these objects. So this is about the Konark. This is the Taj Mahal, and here you see this part of pinnacle is called gilded metal. So a metal from different metal has a different color or different metallic polishes done, that is called gild or gilded metals. And here you can see. So this has been repaired or restored. Both the things has been happened, and here you can found the different hooks also provided for repair purpose at the time of construction they have constructed, and you see there is a different types of disfiguration or discoloration also found at the Taj. So this white part has been repaired. So we have also history of repair of history of Taj. So that we will discuss in whenever I get time, then I will discuss in detail. And here you can see, so whenever you see the conservation point of view of any temples, whether it is medieval temples, whether it is Chandela temples, whether it is Qutub Minar or Humayun tombs, you all over in not in India, even you visit in the South Asian country, you found same kind of landscape that is prepared by and provided by John Marshall, because the structural conservation has a two history. One part before John Marshall and another part after John Marshall, and the third part after independence India. So here you found same kind of landscaping you will found at where Humayun tomb, whether at Taj Mahal, whether you found at Swan Temple Konark, and whether you found the Qutub Minar. So why this has been happening? Because John Marshall make a conservation manual, and before the John Marshall, the conservation work taken by the CPWD. So what kind of restrictive feature of CPWD? So you will found here the Esler masonry. So if there is a Esler masonry used in the structural conservation, you directly click that this conservation done by CPWD India, Central Public Works Departments of India. And after they have doing same kind of things, John Marshall has think about its regional characteristic feature, a special characteristic feature of the architectural complex or the heritage complex. They have make a plan. But unfortunately, whenever you see the landscape of any of the temples, you will find what? So this is called grass bed, this is called bush bed, this is called tree bed, and at the nearest the temples, there is a pathway. So these three or four component you found everywhere. In Taj Mahal, you go and visit, and I hope you may be visited. Then there you also found this grass bed, tree bed, bush bed, and pathway. So this is the, whether this is the original landscape of Sun Temple Konark, or whenever you do the conservation, you only talk about the structural conservation, because structure, any structure has a two function, dual function always. One is their core function to support or to cover or to distribute the load to the ground. But second important function, it must have some aesthetic appeal, or aesthetically it's correct, or beautifully it's carved. So whenever you conserve structurally monument good, then you try to also restore the its ambience, because without ambience, you the definition of heritage is defeated. Because heritage management, the basic concept, the things to be conserved in situ in their own ambience. But whenever you structurally conserve the monument and you deforming their original landscape, then according to my point of view, it's not to be a good things or right thing or right justification with the monument. So this is one of my arguments. Someone may be agree or may disagree. So this is the another aspect of temporary support or using of scaffolding. So most of the in Indian monument you found scaffolding somewhere, some side or somewhere, some sides. Even you visit the large number of monuments, the some parts of the monument are logged on the name of conservation. So what is happening? This is visible here. So this is the tubular scaffolding, and different kind of scaffolding here has been used to for restoration purposes. This is the Kakkan Math Mandir again. The this side is belongs to the Madhya Pradesh and near Gwalior. Kakkan Math Mandir. Here is also Shiv temples and these are in deserted and dilapidated condition. And you can see this is the another Shiv temples also constructed here. So this is the main temple and how they restored it. So after restoration, you see what type of plinth is visible or whether it is structurally stable or not. It's up to us people. We are the saver of the heritage. We are the community who are leader of the heritage, who are doing day and night to conserving and preserving these monuments. So what kind of technological solution is available for that? Because it's here you can see, this is very much important picture for the upcoming student. So if you see the temples are decorated with very good, decorated with the different types of decorative motifs or sculptural motifs. So here all motifs are disappeared and only the bit and violence core material are visible. So this is the original picture. And you see here is the decorative piece. So generally whenever you see, you will found the temple's exterior or facade is surrounded by these kind of sculpture. But here you can found the core material, which is actually constructed on bit and violence. This is the bit and balance method where the temple has been constructed of the Sikhra or Sikhar. So this is the another aspect of the conservation. And this is, you see here, this is the bell, this is the Nat Mandap, and here you can see the step staircase where the temple may approached. So whenever you analyze any structure, so I am putting here you an example of Sun Temple Konark on the basis of materials. So these all materials are chondrolite stone. Here is the door jams that is made of chlorite stone. The laterite stone has been used below the ground. So whenever you talk about the structure conservation, you must talk about its anatomy of the structure, building material of the structure, and their provenance or aging of the materials. And what kind of problem inherent in the material and what kind of inherent technological mistake in the execution, that all kind of things has to be pointed out and written down for the better conservation aspects. You see, this is the first time where the iron as a iron as a building material used at Sun Temple Konark. So these are the different beams that has been used at Sun Temple Konark. But unfortunately, and due to the its heaviness of size, and you always keep in mind that whenever you talk about the heritage structure or ancient building material is quite heavier than the modern building materials. So that is one of the another reason for the collapse of the Sun Temple Konark Rekha Deval. This is the Padavali site of the 64 Yogini Mandir constructed on a circular plan. Someone says this is the key concept where the Edwin Lutyen and Tor Russell and Baker has been taken the idea of the construction of the Sansad Bhavan. So here you also found the different kinds of problem in this 64 Yogini temples. So here you can find all type of problem of interlocking or warping or beeping. All kind of problem is found here. You see here, the alignment is totally compressed due to the conservation due to different loads of the building materials, and these are the drainage part of that inside outside of the temple of 64 Yogini. So here I show you This is also an structure, but this is the vernacular architecture. But why I am showing you that these kind of roof imitated in the stone structure. This is the again tomb of Akbar, that minaret is on repair, and this is the indigenous heritage. Without you know one important thing about the Indian architecture. Today we have different kind of school of planning and architecture and architectural college and Maya, Revit, AutoCAD and all these things. But we are failed to achieve that kind of architectural marvel what we have inherent in past. Why? Because in that time every village had a own school of excellence in terms of architecture, in terms of carpenter, in terms of masala, in terms of sculpture. So every village has a own type of specialization for a particular skill work. And how this thing is remains today itself, you see a village boy is constructing what arch type of structure and playing with this making of house. And similarly in Deepavali, all the kids are constructing different type of houses in house for play purpose. But today kids are what doing? For playing only the PUBG and Candy Crush and all these things. But in village area, yeah, still you will found on Diwali they make their own houses for their own design. And similarly, whenever you go in Maharashtra, they make fort. So that is why in Maharashtra you will found numbers of forts in a different styles. The another picture I would like to show you on the seashore area. Okay, where is that photo picture? You see this picture. This is the castle constructed by a boys on the seashore area. So whenever you visit the sea, somebody and some ask the different kind of house. So architecture inherent in our blood. So whenever you had a professional architect also, then you also comment on that this thing has to be done like this thing. So what we have to do, we have to revive all the guilds of architectural activity or architectural involved people or skilled people. We have to innovate them, we have to train them, because they forget about what they are doing. But their remnants of this capability is still there. This is the site at Mithavali. So why I am showing this Mithavali sites? It is in very much deserted condition and it is restored by ASI and especially by KK Muhammad sir, and he has told lots of story about the document and all that things. But why it is important? So whenever you opt about the AutoCAD, Revit, Maya and artificial intelligence and all that, then Leica, there is a 3D scan microscope. We have lots of technological advanced option, but without knowing about the ancient literary source like Silp Shastra, Silp Ratna, Narad Silp Shastra, you cannot able to construct the temple. Temple is not like that ki ye isme wall ho gaya, ye iska foundation ho gaya, ye iska roof ho gaya. No, there has a definite plan, there is a definite formula that has to be fixed on that only and that way only. So knowing the all advanced equipment, tools and technology and digital platform, you should also know the traditional formula and traditional text and traditional literary source. On the basis of that, all has been constructed. Another important point about these temples are not constructed on the plan and elevation, draw on the what you can say butter paper or the drawing sheets. Almost all the temple construction plan, elevation, all the things has been draw on the sand draw on the rocky strata, and that kind of evidences we found at the Bhojpur temples. You found the different components of the structural components draw on the working drawing on the rocky strata. Similarly, you found in Odisha style of temples, the entire things has to be drawn on the sands. So the traditional knowledge system, you have to cope with the modern instrument or modern technological solution what you have, then you can able to give the proper justification for structural conservation. So last thing I would like to show, okay, so these are the important temples, these are the lesser known monuments, these are the mosque or idgah in the Delhi, and what kind of conservation taken place. You, this is on visual sides. So you have to talk about the centrally protected A class monument, B class monument, C class monument, and accordingly you have to prepare, or you have to generate awareness among the peoples how to conserve it, why the conservation is important for technological aspect, for scientific aspect, for historical aspects, and accordingly you have to judge and take the decision. This is the again shading part of that structural conservation to save this emerging elephant at Odisha. This is the Mauryan period structure and how they have conserved it. It's visible. So here lots of things could be done on the structural part. This is the Aurangabad fort. You must have heard about the Aurangabad. Behind this Bibi Ka Maqbara, there is a group of cave, and you see this is the condition of that pillar. This is the condition of the pillars. So this one is the unfinished cave at Aurangabad. This is the Nalanda. You can see the structural structure of that, the Nalanda structure. You can find this is the brick structure and what kind of problem is occurring, dislodging, bulging, the mortar is losing, so all kind of problems. So here you have also talked about how to estimate the load of this building, what kind of probing, modern, always use modern or advanced instrument for analysis, or analytical instrument always to be advanced, but execution method, or according to my point of view, always indigenous, because scientific analysis is essential to estimate the all the things, all the problem, but execution you have to keep your own traditional mode and method. See, this is very much important. Identify the sites, anyone? Aap logo ko pata hai, this is the Togol right of India, or it's the side of Ajanta cave, and cave is a place where absentia of light, and they have constructed at Ajanta. And you see the, on the name of technological innovation and all these things, the side is in this state. This state is due to the experimentation. So all the advanced equipment are produced in anywhere, but they all are experimented at Indian heritage sites. So this is the one of the best example. Before that there is a Kovac light system, nowadays there is a flip shop lighting system, and all kind of problem you can find here also. And this is the Vijay Mandal at Bidisa. A huge temple converted into mosque, and this has to be restored, but due to the different causes it has to be restored. And this is the again the closing the door at Ajanta. They have used this kind of alteration or structural addition at the sites, and they have used different kind of glass and this work. This is the again Nalanda, and here you also found same kind of landscaping also found here. this is the Karle cave. In front of there is another temple is come up and obstruct the view of the original heritage structure. So in India you have the all the things. You have good thing also, you have bad thing also, you have challenge also, you have the issue also, and as well as you have option also. So it depends upon you people and we people how to approach the sites. And this is again, these are the reproduction method how they adopted. So this is the pillar is recasted. So casting is also one of the used, you can say the prevailed conservation technique in Indian monuments. So casting is very much important feature found at the cave architecture. So here is also the process of casting is going on again at the Elephanta cave. So this is the Elephanta. This is very interesting things. This is the Udayagiri where the Bhu Uddhar Mudra of the by the Bara. You will find all kind of things. So what is the structural problem here? You will get here all these three parts of this universe, Akash Lok, or iske niche Patal Lok, Sesshai Vishnu. And where is the Vara? In front of this, there is a pond. It's full of kichar. Saladi se bhara hua hona chahiye. But nowadays, what is happening? The side is encroaching and now they got dry up. So whenever you study the structure, or know the anatomy of the structure, then also know the mythological relation with the sites. So if there is a vara, in front of there is a kichar, because the vara is residence is kichar. So wo kichar se nikal ke bahar nikal ke dhar mudra kar rahe hai. So that side also be preserved or conserved or rejuvenated to retain the holistic conservation approach of a particular sites. So this is the one of the important aspect at here. And this is the last. This is the Indo-Nepal architecture we found in the Basali. This is the wooden architecture, complete structure, Basali part. This is the Shiv temples, and this is also in very much in dilapidated condition. All the woodens are rotten and the chinsets are rusted, and lots of problem you will get here.